Thank you, and welcome to our final concert of the 2021 season here at Carter Park. We're so glad that we were able to have a season, and so glad that you're all able to join us tonight to celebrate the end of it. It seems like summer comes, and then it's so fleeting, it's gone by the time we realize it's here. But that's New England for you. And tonight, we have we're celebrating our Italian Festa. This is the music of Italy. So if you're Italian, you'll recognize a lot of music. And like Amelia and Paul, you will recognize a lot of this music. And if you're not Italian, you are honorary Italians tonight. So we're all Italian tonight, except for Sergei Rachmaninoff, who was Russian. But he wrote what he called the Italian polka. And we're going to play that for you now. This is our first time playing it. This music was a gift from one of our clarinetists, Bill Williams. Thank you, Bill. Bill provided this music for us. And by the way, while we're talking about Bill Williams, we'll throw a shout out to the Fitchburg Military Band, which Bill conducts, and they're beginning their concerts last Sunday. And we'll continue on the 22nd and the 29th at Cogsall Park, right, in Fitchburg. So Sunday afternoons at 2 o'clock. So you get to see Bill do his thing there. But anyway, here's Sergei Rachmaninoff's Italian Polka. Thank you. What you just heard was one of the earliest numbers in our band's library. This piece of music has been played by our band for more than 100 years. And, of course, these are classic Italian folk songs. First, you heard the Garibaldi hymn, followed by Funiculi, Funicula, and then you heard Ue Marie, followed by Santa Lucia, which we send out to my grandmother, who was, her name was Lucia. And after that was Luoghi Affaturati, and then back to Ue Marie for the ending. And we would like to inform you that these concerts here at Carter Park don't happen by themselves. They're brought to you through a combination of sponsorships, and we want to acknowledge all of our sponsors because they make all of this music possible so that you can come here and not pay a dime and hear some live music. And where can you do that? So we want to thank the City of Leominster, Dean Mazzarella's office, the Office of the Mayor, the Leominster Cultural Commission through a grant from the Massachusetts Cultural Council, and we want to mention, especially this summer, the Leominster Cultural Council did something really nice for us this year, and we want to thank them for the grant that made possible a new electronic instrument that you can't see, but I guess Evan's going to hold it up there a little bit. If you hear, hopefully you do hear, timpani, and last week when we did our Chinese intermezzo, you heard a gong, and that's a digital electronic instrument that can make all kinds of percussion sounds. So we don't have to, well, we can't fit timpani back here anyway, but now we can have them without having to lug them around, which is really great. So we thank the Leominster Cultural Commission so much for that, making that not only the instrument possible, but now we have a 29th mouth to feed. Yeah, so thanks for that. And, of course, the Music Performance Trust Fund, which is administered through the American Federation of Musicians, Local 173 in Fitchburg. Every time you buy music through Spotify or Amazon, a very small, or if you still buy CDs, or if you've gone back, like so many people have, to vinyl, when you make that purchase, a very small amount goes into this trust fund that's made available to sponsor concerts such as this that are free to the public and open to the public. So thank you to the MPTF. And we'll tell you some more thank yous and some more news as we continue with our concert. Next we have two folk songs that are traditional for our band to play. I mentioned at last week's concert that you know, this is, in a way, tonight's concert is kind of a recreation of the concerts that we used to play every summer at the Saladini Club, which doesn't exist anymore, up on Lincoln Terrace, off of between Graham Street and Marguerite Avenue there. And we used to play, you know, all of our classics there, many of which you'll hear tonight. The next two were always on the program. And for whatever reason, they're always played one after another. I don't know why. Do you know why that was done? I don't either. We'll never know. But the band's founder, Gaspare Bisceglie, Steve's grandfather, and Lori and Kathy and everybody, all the Bisceglies are here. Gaspare wrote these two arrangements, two folk songs, A Tazza e Caffè, which means a cup of coffee, and Come bella a stagione, which means how beautiful are the seasons. So these are the notes that our founder wrote many, many, many years ago. I've transcribed them over the years so that we don't have to read the miniature manuscript, which is very hard for us to read. And as we get older, this is easier. So now we have computer-generated parts that are easy for the musicians to read. So no excuses. So here we go. A tazza caffè followed by Come bella a stagione. Our next selection is somewhat of a mystery. This is one that we never played at the Saladini Club, but it was in the band's library. I imagine it was probably lost in the Bichelieu basement somewhere. Ben, wow. You got more? The gift that keeps on giving. I'll take a look at it after. This one I found in the music that I got from the Bisceglias after Vinnie's passing, and then I put it away. We'll wait for the festivities. I don't think they got the email. The police are good. The police actually turn off their sirens when they go by, but... Okay, so back to my story. I put this one in the library where it languished, and anyway, it was probably 40 years between the first time or the previous time the band played this and when we resurrected it a few years ago. But it's a marvelously beautiful, simple melody. And if you remember Julius LaRosa, anybody old enough to remember Julius LaRosa? Yeah. Okay, so he's the one that Arthur Godfrey famously fired. Wonderful singer. And he had a hit with this in 1955. And those of you musicians will be interested to know, this melody is entirely diatonic, which means it never strays from the eight tones of the major scale. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. It never leaves those eight notes, which is kind of unusual. When I was in college, we had a project. Did they make you do this? Where you had to, I think it was either ear training or harmony, you had to bring in a tune, a popular tune that was entirely diatonic. Did you have to do that? Did you? No? You must have had an easy teacher. But anyway, there are some. But oddly enough, Do, Re, Mi is not one of them. But there are some. My Romance is one. Anyway, this one is completely diatonic. Beautiful song. We're going to bring it to you tonight, Domani, which means not to be confused with the one from Annie.
Thank you.
That was the Woodpecker Song. That's a traditional Italian polka. It's been recorded by groups as diverse as Glenn Miller recorded this. I have never heard it. Anybody heard Glenn Miller's version of this? Anybody? No, I never have either. But I read that he recorded it, so it must be true. We're going to continue in just a moment with a great Italian folk song. But before we do, I want to mention that we want to send a special thanks to the office of the mayor, Dean Mazzarella, and to his administrative assistant, Michelle Netto, for her tireless efforts in coordinating all of the logistics at Carter Park. And as anybody in, yeah, she deserves a round of applause. Anybody in the business world knows the real work gets done by the administrative assistants, which is not to say that the mayor doesn't do real work. I'm sure he does. And we want to thank David Letters, a.k.a. D. Grease. Is he here tonight? Yeah? Ah, right in front of me. David does all of our publicity, and we got a beautiful article in the Sentinel this year, so thank you, Dee, for all that you do for us. And I want to thank Ron Girouard. Ron does the video production for LTV. And I was just telling Ron before the concert today, I was listening to a little bit of last week's concert, I should say watching, and just a really nice job, Ron, and we want to thank you for all of your efforts. And we want to take this opportunity to remind you that if you like the music, you can help to perpetuate it by becoming a sponsor. And there's no minimum. You know, you can give us 50 cents. We'll be happy to get it. But our band is a 501c3 nonprofit organization, so any donations you give are fully tax deductible. So we hope you'll consider giving and joining the list on the program. It's really that bucket of money that makes all of the new music that we play possible. So thanks to those of you who have sponsored already, and thank you to those of you who will be sponsoring in the future. And we want to remind you, or inform you rather, that we will be extending our season, so to speak, in December. So if you like what you hear tonight, come back on December 12th, not here. But we'll be at City Hall Auditorium for our, what had been an annual Christmas concert. Can we still call it annual if we missed a year? So it'll be our annual Christmas concert, but it won't be the, there'll be a gap. It's like the Major League Baseball when they put the asterisks in the record book, you know. So we missed last year, but we have all that pent-up music that we have to bring you this Christmas. So we hope you'll join us on December 12th, and that concert, again, is free of charge, so we hope you'll consider joining us. It's really a marvelous. If you haven't been, ask people who have been. It's really a wonderful time. City Hall is all decorated with the Festival of Trees, and it's really a great take. And as I like to say, it's worth the price of admission. So, yes, and the, well, I don't like to advertise that. We don't want people to come only for the food. But like any Italian hosts, we make sure our guests leave with a full tummy. So you have that to look forward to as well. So we continue now with the music of Ernesto de Curtis, in an arrangement by Harold Walters, who will pop up later in the program. Who's going to play the solo, gentlemen? Joe, try to stay awake. I know it's difficult. You're awake enough to play this? Okay, good. So Joe McCarthy will be performing the trumpet solo on Come Back to Sorrento, otherwise known as Torno a Sorrento. Thank you. Joe McCarthy. His mother was Italian. Here's a great old Italian folk song, Oh Mama, otherwise known as E la Luna Mezzo Mare. The next one is one that we never played at the Saladini Club because it didn't exist yet. This is the one that I brought to the band, actually, a long time ago, too. This is a medley of themes from the various Godfather movies, and it's really well done by an arranger named Jack Bullock. So in this, you're going to hear the theme from Godfather 1, Godfather 2. You'll hear Kay's theme. What are the other ones? Tarantella. The Godfather Tarantella, the Mazurka. Thank you. Come Live Your Life With Me. Festa March. Is that it, Steve? Speak Softly, Love. So you'll hear all of those. And a great arrangement, as I said, by Jack Bullock. This is the Godfather Trilogy, and if you happen to have our CD number 17, this is on it. And if you don't have it, I'm afraid to say you can't get it because it's out of print. I think I still have a box and a file cabinet in my garage, so if you're interested, let me know. Thank you. Thank you. How about our soloists? Rich Given on trumpet. Debbie Henke on oboe. Dan Walker on trombone. Hannah Bitterman on piccolo. Thank you. Everybody, take a bow, everybody. In 1910, an apprentice bandmaster came over from San Giovanni, Italy, and settled here in Leominster. And sometime after that, he wrote this march. His name was Gaspare Bisceglia, and he founded this band. And over the years at the Saladini Club, when we would play the Italian parade and the concert at night, this became so loved by the audience that they would request it many times. We would play a two-hour concert up there, and we'd play this probably six times in the 2 hours. But the audience only knew it by the number that the conductor would call out, because they used to have these march folios, so they'd have to flip the pages. So he'd say number 17. This had the place of number 17 in the folio. So the audience would hear Gaspare say number 17. And they would, so they would ask. They'd say number 17. They'd shout it from the back, number 17. So it became known as number 17, but the real name is the SRTV march. SR for San Rocco, TV for reasons that I think I put in the program. So this is the SRTV march, otherwise known as number 17. We're only going to play it once, though. Okay, we're approaching the end, and before we do that, I want to acknowledge the musicians who've done such a wonderful job this summer. Thank God, without illness, and although some infirmity, but no illness. We especially want to welcome back Phil Darby, who's back tonight for the first time. Phil and Pat, his wife here in the flute section, have been here almost as long as John and I. So they're, when one of them is missing, we know it. So anyway, we're going to start in the clarinet section. I'd like to introduce everybody from left to right. In the front row, we have Lou Stamos and Joe Pisano Jr. In the second row, we have Bill Williams, Dave Dackwell, and thank you, Dave, for filling in the summer, too. Sharon DiCicco and Phil Darby. On bass clarinet, Steve Archambault. On bassoon, John Strang. In the saxophone section, from left to right, I have to give a special shout-out to my wife, Judy Piermarini, who has her own fans. And tolerates all of the music all over the house and the sorting rack and the downstairs and all that stuff. And on alto saxophone, Steve Dauphiné and Mark Staniford. Thank you. Behind them, the French horns. Well, I haven't gotten to them on the list yet. But if you'd rather have them go before you, Tabitha, we'll do that. I appreciate that, yes. Well, I do appreciate that because, well, see, that's why John gives me a list every year, so I don't, because if I just look and say him, her, then I forget someone. So, yeah, we'll go here to the flutes in the front. Well, we might as well do the oboe, Debbie Henke, and then the flutes from left to right, Pat Darby, Hannah Bitterman, and Michelle Hefner. And the French horns from right to left, Tabitha Greenlees, Jean Paella, and Mary Kate Bourne. Mary Kate's another one who's, you know, 30 years plus, right? How many? Oh, you couldn't be that old. A baritone, yes, you do. Baritone horn, Charlie Leach. In the trumpets from right to left, and I want a special shout out too to Joe McCarthy. We kind of made fun of him tonight for yawning, and he was back here saying, "But I have a newborn." Joe stepped in last week and conducted beautifully during my solo, and Joe's a great asset in our band. And next to Joe, we want to thank Rich Given for being with us all season. Marvelous to have you, Rich. And next to Rich is Phil Nermy, who we lost last week for a week, but glad to have him back this week. And Rick O'Leary, and the person that I had told myself I was going to mention first and forgot to do that. But at the end of the trumpet section is John DiCicco, and we were joking with him tonight about that term, other duties as assigned, right? Everybody has their job description at work. And then at the bottom it says other duties as assigned, so that they can get away with asking you to do anything. And they say, well, it's in your job description. Well, very little of what John does is in his job description. But he does everything to make these concerts happen, from arranging with the city to changing the light bulbs to putting up the signs, bringing the chairs. I mean, it's an unbelievable task that he does, and I would like you all to please recognize the person who really makes this happen, John DiCicco. And just a few more to go. Hope those are firecrackers. On tuba, Fred Bernhardt back there. And with us tonight, Chris Lucander on string bass, hiding behind the music stand there. On drum set, Jason Sharon. Stand up, Jay. And as I mentioned earlier, our proud to say timpanist and auxiliary percussionist Evan Pinsano. See, even with a list. Forget the trombone section. From left to right, Dan Walker, Ken Anderson, who's another 40-year person or close to it, and Cam Rodicklins. Sorry, guys. The great composer Berlioz had a saying, never look at the trombone section, it only encourages them. So perhaps that was a Freudian slip. Earlier we did come back to Sorrento, an arrangement by Harold Walters, and I told you he would pop up again in the program. He wrote this next one. It's called Instant Concert. This was my mother's favorite, and we send it up to her every year. This is for Rita. See how many of these melodies you can name. They go by pretty fast, and sometimes two at a time. This is a very unique piece of music, Instant Concert. Thank you. Please join us December 12th at City Hall for our annual Christmas concert. And we close tonight, as we do every season, with this one of the most beautiful arrangements ever written for anything or anybody, This is Carmen Dragon's version of America the Beautiful. Thank you for being with us. Have a good night.